educate children well are more to be honored than they who produce them. For these only gave them life, those the art of living well. Thus spake the great philosopher and thinker Aristotle. Today we have with us at R Plus Talks Dr. Sangeeta Srivastava, Principal and CAO at the Kandivali Education Society's SVPV Vidhyalaya and Shri T.P. Bhatia Science College. For the last 19 years, Maharashtra State Awardee 2017, she firmly believes that it is foolish to deny a tablet to a child because the child is obviously more attracted to the tablet than to ordinary paper books. So why not benefit from this, making learning process not only useful, but also exciting. After all, children, like all of us, do best what they like. During the last 29 years, you've actually been a part, and not just a part, you've actually been pioneering, integrating technology into classroom learning, trying to make it fun for students and teachers. What do you feel is the greatest benefit of educational technology?
As you said, that we cannot deny that technology attracts children more. So in 2009, when we decided to make our school digital, it was my management told me that it was a big dream that you are having. And I said, why not? We should dream big, because ours is a free education system school. We cannot charge any fees, and Kandivali Education Society is known for not having any donations all these years. I have never seen. So how to achieve that? How to make all the 45 classrooms digital? Because that was the first step. In those days, tablets or smartphones were not there. So I don't know, we say that if you want something, raste ban jate kind of thing.
Okay.
And we got some sponsors, and the first time the company whom we approached, they brought down the cost so much, which was affordable for us. And I met each and every parent, all 3,000 of them, you know, one by one in groups, to explain them, to show them what, how it is going to benefit. And they agreed for a small fees of 100 rupees per year.
And all right.
Yes, we began like that, and then gradually seeing the benefit of it, because initially the teachers who were with us for last 30 years, and some teachers were on the verge of retirement, and they said, ma'am, at this stage you are subjecting us to this torture of learning, you know, I have never even, I don't even operate my phone, and now you want me to operate a computer and a digital classroom. But the same teachers, many of them, they came out and they were so proactive. They attended the trainings because they realized the benefit. They could see the change in the children, because using a digital board and a very a content which they got immediate attention of the students, which otherwise was very difficult, because the classrooms
correct,
are very large
correct,
in our school.
Correct.
Almost 60 to 70 students in a class.
Every class, yeah.
So humanly not possible to reach out to each and every child and understand whether the child has followed or not. So this technology brought a big difference
big
in the
difference.
Classroom. Gradually everyone, there were around 100 teachers at that time in my secondary section. And one by one, everybody followed the line.
Adapted.
Few were very smart, so they adopted it very fast.
Yes.
Others, looking at the advantage of the technology, they also started. And today, my teachers cannot do without a without some or the other digital or technology or anything.
Okay. So it was a task, the transition from teacher to tech savvy teacher.
Of course,
right?
Of course.
And it is always going to be that way, because children today are natives to technology.
Yes.
Whereas we teachers, I mean, we cannot be as expert or as fast or as quick as
Definitely.
Them. How did you, so I want to go a little bit more into the nitty-gritty. How did you manage to, I know you said that yes, they readily agreed, but how did you manage to change that viewpoint from the teacher-centered classroom to the learner-centered classroom?
So initially there was a lot of non-acceptance, most of them said that they didn't want to go into this because they thought that now they are too old to start learning something new. But yes, as you said, there were many workshops. We have been holding a lot of workshops which counsel the teachers also. I myself, and then there were younger teachers who took the lead and they were very happy doing it. Seeing the students' reaction in their classroom, the kind of discipline it brought to the classrooms, they found that they gradually realized that they have to change. And then that was the time when everywhere the change was happening. And some schools were very ahead, but they were not aided schools like ours.
Correct.
So we were the first school who brought in this technology.
A government aided school. Yes.
After us, trustees of Sharda Ashram came to see our school to understand how I was able to do it.
And that too from with a minimum 100 rupees per annum charge. Okay, you have been known to introduce disciplining with dance, dramatics, music, sports. And not only has this restricted the dropouts, it has improved and enhanced the overall discipline. How did you manage to do that?
As I told you earlier, that the students that come to my school, being a free education system, you can very well imagine that they come from economically deprived backgrounds. So obviously they have discipline issues because the place from where they come. They speak rough language, bad words, or they don't listen to the teacher. So I discover teachers have been coming to me and complaining that in each and every class there would be at least 10 boys like that whom teacher finds very, very irritating. And they won't listen, they won't sit quietly in the class, they are hyperactive, or if they go to the washroom they don't come back and teacher has to go after them. And they fail, they don't pass their tests, and very unruly behavior. So teachers would just come to me with complaints, me or the vice principal, and tell him that we don't want this child in the class. And then when I would, I have a very different, our management has a very different vision that this school is like here to make lives of children, and if we remove them from the school,
correct.
Where would they go? They don't even go for a private SSC, you know, they just drop out. And we have followed with such children, the children who have failed in 9th standard and they have not come back to the school as a private student. They just go out and they become, they just don't follow any career, they become criminals, they go anywhere, they fall in bad company. So looking at this, it was decided that I had in my mind decided that I can't remove a child or extricate a child from the school. So what to do, because in every class there were at least 10 children. So I told these teachers, okay, I understand that yours is 70 children in a classroom and very difficult if 10 children don't listen. So rest of the children shouldn't suffer. So what we'll do, give those 10 children to me. I'll make my own classroom. And that way, every year I get some 80 students in a class, 72
Fifth,
to 80.
6, 7th, 8th, 9th,
every class
ten.
They would
into
be.
Into 10.
Into 10.
Oh my God.
So what we do is our management has been very kind. Like if I come with an idea, they accept it. They have trust on me. They believe in me. And that's how we did it. What we did was I appointed a dance teacher. Then there was a music teacher who came in. Then there was a dramatics teacher who came in, because this has to be paid by the management and we can't charge any fees from the children. So we have a team of these teachers. Then there's a counselor who comes in. And I did an experiment, you can say. I said that, okay, children, because the first condition was for the teachers, you don't have to label them. I called them activity students. Now these children, every last period, they have to come to my class. We are planning some activity with you. So initially teachers and everybody know that this is a naughty child in the class, that's why he's being taken out. So that was the first task, to make the teachers understand that they don't have to label them. Because I wanted to give them a dignity of a different kind.
Exactly.
Because they have been labeled from the beginning. Yes. Naughty hai, padhta nahi hai, fail hota hai.
Just out of curiosity, did this work?
Yeah, it has been working.
And one question, did you manage to integrate that child back into that classroom?
Yes, the child is in the class only. Only what I did was, like, it was January when I decided. I said, okay, we have a Maharashtra Divas coming up. We always present program. So this group of, we took some 70 children and said they will present a program this time, and the dramatics dance teacher and the counselor, plus some teachers who showed interest, they were teaching them also after some time, making them wait after school, teaching them mathematics and English, so that they also study. And okay. The incentive was given that you are going to present this program, but I want to see a good result so that everybody doesn't label you that you don't study. This worked so well that this 4 months children were just practicing 1 hour after the school, and the teachers who were dealing with these children, they came to me and said, "Ki ma'am, these children are so good, why everybody talks bad about them?"
Excellent.
Because
excellent.
When they got to spend their energy in something which which was positive.
So all they needed was a positive opportunity.
Positive approach and opportunity.
And you gave it to them.
So they got it. So I did a research also. I did a pre-test and a post-test after their test. Pre-test was taken of the first term examination, what marks they had got. Okay. And we did not work on teaching at all. I wanted to make them happy. And I had read somewhere that a happy child
performs better.
And then really it happened that initial days were tough because these children also did not believe in this.
Yes.
Ye kaise possible hai? And then dramatics teacher found it very difficult. One day she came crying, "Ma'am, aapne kaise bachche mujhe de diye?" I had come to this school thinking that I will do dramas and teach children drama. Yes. And these children, they don't listen, they bully me, they do that. One or two lectures were enough. And then, but at the end, on the 1st of May, they presented the program and they gave their feedback. The child who was in 10th standard, he scored 85% marks in his board.
I'll echo your words back. Agar tum sachche dil se kuch chahte ho, the entire universe will conspire.
Everything is possible. I tell you one thing, that we are prejudiced as teachers, as educators. We think that children coming from a particular background or if they don't have support from home, they always do like this. But if you look at the other side of the story, the other side of the story is each child has at least one good thing. And as a teacher, we should look at, catch hold of that good thing, make the child feel wanted, let his esteem rise.
And let positive energy do the rest.
Yes. So this research was presented in Tilak College of Pune in B.Ed. College.
Fantastic.
Because working? Because it was a research, full-fledged.
So I presented a paper. It's all documented.
Documented. Complete. And paper is presented, and every
Fantastic.
Year we do that.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
You were speaking about the vision of the school management.
Yes.
Right? So I'm sure that when we are looking at any educational technology, we are always looking at the school vision, the class vision, the mission, yes? So, how do you manage to sync all this together?
So, the vision of Kandivali Education Society is that any child who comes into our premises should not be deprived of education just because he cannot afford. So, that has been our mission for last, I am here since last 19 years in this school and college as a principal. I have been working towards that, making my teachers understand this vision. And the management has got certain ideas, like we have a Vidyotejak scheme for the children who want to study and cannot afford. They get scholarships from the management. Social and compassionate approach has to be taken so that these children, many of them, just today one child came and he has got a Rotary Award for getting good marks in SSC. Under adverse conditions, and I have a picture of that child today. He brought to show me, he's just passed his SSC. He's a Gujarati medium child. He has come from Gujarat. He lost both his parents 10 years back, and one of his uncles has put him in a hostel, which is also our president Satish Dattani is a president for that hostel also. And they have kept the child into the hostel without charging any fees from him. He is studying in our school, he has been studying in our school. He passed his SSC with 75% marks.
Fantastic.
And we have admitted him in our commerce college. He aspires to become a CA. So this is one story, but every day I come across story
multiple
in my
stories.
Schools.
Yes. Whenever we are adapting technology in schools, you actually will find that the best technology is one that empowers the students. Like as you said, the students are not of a strata where they can afford high-end coaching institutions. So empower the students to be in control of their own learning.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So how do you manage to look at that as a reference point while introducing some technology?
When we talk of digital classroom, they also have some opportunities for children to log in at their home and look at those videos or some lessons which are there developed by them. But then it has its constraints that child should have a computer at home. Not only computer, he should have internet so that he can log into it. They give you a student ID where the child can go back and look into those lessons if teacher has used some content, okay. Digital content. But I came across some, nowadays the books are being made, I think even your company makes that book, where Robo the books. Child, the workbooks,
Robo books,
where the child has that book with him and the child just uses a smartphone and at his own ease, at his own pace, where he is comfortable with, he can revise, he can redo, he can write the answers, he can get the guidance just like a tuition teacher. So nowadays, talking of tuition teacher, our children, the children, although they don't pay any fees in the school, but each and every child goes for a tuition. And if you ask the parents, how did they manage to pay fee, they even take loans to pay tuition fees.
My God.
And the kind of tuition teachers are there, I don't want to comment on that. Because they are just making money and these children, the parents are uneducated. Most of the children are first generation learners. And most of the parents are daily wages people. Either they are, you know, auto rickshaw drivers.
I've touched the raw nerve here.
Yes, they are auto rickshaw drivers or vegetable vendors. And they have no time to look after their children's study. So they just send them to the tuition teacher. And tuition teacher, because they can't afford a nice fees, so they get the cheaper tuition teacher, you can imagine what happens there.
Yes.
So I feel that if this kind of equipment a child has in a hand,
yes,
which is not a tablet, because I feel the tablet, then there are so many other fallouts of that.
Yes. So this something which can be as easy as a smartphone or
yes,
a laptop or something.
And very focused.
Right.
Okay. We don't need them to go to so many sites and download things and like that.
Basically, right now focus on the curriculum.
It's almost like a teacher sitting by your side.
Exactly.
And whatever you have not followed, the child can just ask you.
24/7 teacher.
Child doesn't ask the teacher. I have seen children, very few children ask questions. I'm talking of the children of, kind of children I have in my school.
So would you love to have such technology where maybe the child could actually message the digital teacher and get an answer back also if there is a doubt?
Yes. Yes.
Like maybe the teacher has solved a sum in a particular manner.
It's like a helpline.
Helpline, absolutely. Yes, fantastic. Okay, so here is my controversial question.
Okay.
Yes. Students are now scoring 99 and even 100%. You look at the CBSE and the ICSE results and they are talking about students having scored 100%. One, is this a healthy trend? Two, I know that the Maharashtra State Board has now at least gone back to the 20% internal assessments. And so for this year's academic students, the loss will not be that hard to bear. What do you think about this?
As far as math and science is concerned, I'm all for 100 marks. Because we have to admit that we are teaching our children, we are preparing a robo who can solve all the answers. We are teaching our children from the examination point of view. That
so 100 marks definitely means the child is not perfect, but
he can
the child
score.
Is perfect in this curriculum.
Yes, his memory is very good.
Perfect.
He can solve the sum. His understanding is
and
excellent.
And the presentation skills are also very good.
But when it comes to languages, there I have my doubts. How did a child get 100 out of 100 in English? Shakespeare, even at this age, I have studied MA in English. I have studied Shakespeare. But I cannot say that I know Shakespeare fully. 100 marks means what? Final, maximum.
Yeah.
You can't go beyond that.
Exactly.
But literature, what we are telling our children, that literature has a limit? No, the imagination and creativity doesn't have a limit. And we are teaching a child that, okay, it's okay to get 100 marks in languages. And talking about internal marks, yes, children should be getting the facility of internal marks. They should get. The question here was not of not getting internal marks or getting internal marks. The problem was at the way it was given. The problem came when marks were just given like that without, just to, you know, boost your result, you would just give marks to children like that without testing them, without exposing them to what the syllabus or the curriculum of oral marks.
Without actually grading them as per this their was happening. Capabilities.
And rather than, I would say if you fall sick, rather than treating your illness, why you got fever, just give the medicine to curb the fever. Okay. This was what was done.
Sometime later, the fever will come back worse.
Yes, exactly. It will turn into a cancer.
Oh my God. It's been a pleasure having you here. And folks, I am sure you've got your answers and more than what you bargained for. Thank you very much. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having me here. Thank you so much.